Okay, how to write a conclusion. Okay, so very often a conclusion is overlooked because I've often heard students told that you just write something that mirrors the introduction. And actually a conclusion is far more than that. And if you have a look at this worksheet that I've given you in your books, you'll see that. Who remembers the acronym for the conclusion?
LATE.
LATE, good girl. Okay, so let's just put our acronym up here. Okay, the L is what?
Link.
What are we linking it to?
The thesis statement.
The thesis. Okay, let's look at the A.
Author's purpose.
Author's purpose. And the next T is the?
It's the topic of the essay.
The topic of the essay. And the next T?
It's the 3-point of essay, synthesize, use the last sentence of each main body paragraph.
Good boy. And Molly?
End well, like the grammar.
End well. Okay. Now the key thing about LATE is while we want to have all of these elements in a conclusion, they don't have to be literally 1, 2, 3, 4 in that order. Of course, the one at the end does, because you can't end well and then just not use it to end. So that is like your grabber. That is like a really clever quote, something that sums up what you've been talking about. If you can't think of a really clever thing, what's the advice? If in doubt,
don't do anything.
Leave it out. If in doubt, leave it out. It's the same with the grabber at the beginning in the introduction. If you can't think of something clever, don't put something lame in, because that just weakens your whole essay, especially in the introduction, because that's the very first thing that your marker or reader sees. So, if in doubt,
leave it out.
Very good. Okay. The link, we've had a link all the way through our essay. The introduction was our signpost that showed us where we were going with the main body paragraphs. And so, just as that is all linked together, so the conclusion is also linked to that. We should have a link right the way through the essay. At no time should I leave one of the paragraphs in your essay and wonder what it was about. Every one of your paragraphs, if I read it in isolation, will be about the main topic. And this was the thesis question. And most of you said that you went in opposition to this. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay. So, first thing I need to do is make my link. I also know, and I'm aware in the back of my mind, that I need to discuss the author's purpose. And I need to cover the topic of the essay. Now, some of these two would appear to be the same. Would you agree? That could be a bit confusing.
Yes.
We know that we're talking about that socks are not better than greasers. Sorry, socias are not better than greasers. So it would be easy to think that maybe that's our topic. But in actual fact, it's not. So especially if we were thinking about the message that the author wanted to give us, what would we say that the topic of the essay was? Any ideas? Yeah?
The socks made you think, like how they made you think of the better citizen, the degree of.
Good boy, you're certainly on the right track there. So if this was our link, this was our thesis, our question, and we said that actually the socias are not better citizens. Further to that, I might think that our author is actually trying to show us that it doesn't matter how much money you've got, having money doesn't necessarily make you a better person. Would you agree with that?
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Okay, so right now I'm kind of, you know, you have a page when you do an essay that for planning?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, so you're used to planning quite at the very beginning for your introduction and your main body paragraphs, but this is a really good place to actually go back to your planning page and do a little bit more planning for your conclusion. Because a powerful conclusion can actually leave your mark on your reader feeling a lot more positive about your writing. And what you want is your marker to finish the last word of your essay and think, wow, that was well done. Really, that was quite clever. I enjoyed that. Okay, so the socials are better citizens than the greasers. So I'm just planning now. Okay, so I'm back on my planning page. So I'm thinking that the author's purpose is to, these two are linked together. Author's purpose is to show that having money does not necessarily, is that spelled correctly?
Yeah.
Can you check it please?
Maybe. You're an English teacher.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean I know how to spell everything correctly.
You should know.
It looks right.
I should, but should I?
It does, it's right.
Are you sure? How do you know?
No. Because I'm smart. Thank
you. Better citizen. You should test everything. Don't believe everything. You should test everything. What's wrong with temperature? Okay. So, this sentence here, does this actually answer both of these things?
Yes.
It answers author's purpose, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the topic?
Yeah.
Okay, so now, I wouldn't have known really about the topic of the essay until I sat down to do my exam. So you can't go in pre-prepared for that. This is stuff you actually have to do in your exam. All right, so I already know what my 3 points were because I can go back on my 3 main body paragraphs and read the Elm part of Peel, because if Peel as a main body paragraph, as a paragraph it holds an idea all of its own. I know that that idea is linked to this, there's very much the link there, but this is almost, your Peel is almost like a mini essay in itself, because we're making a point, much like the thesis statement. We've got evidence, we've got explanations, and then we've made this link, but we've also gone further in the link. Remember I told you how to go a little bit wider? So you're not just summarizing this, you've gone a little bit wider. Do you all remember that?
No.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, well you may not have been here for that. Okay, so for me to be able to synthesize my 3 points, I need to actually read the 3 L's that I have from my main body paragraphs. I'll read the L from the first one, the second one, and the third one. And then I'll sort of get a real idea of actually what I've proved in my essay. Okay, so I needed initially to find 3 parts in the book that showed that the socks were better citizens. So who's done the 2 Peel paragraphs? 2. Haven't you done 2? Done 1? Okay, so what have you got, Michaela, for what your point in your main body paragraph?
I'm not sure actually.
Okay, Carlos, what's the point in your Peel paragraph?
My Peel, we did this on Friday, because that wasn't me.
Okay, this is not going well. All right, Ethan.
Cherry has been trapped in her own personality forever, and she needs to escape.
That was
Oh, that's right. I did it on the wrong one. That's right. I remember the wrong one. I didn't know what to do.
The
breezes
are more responsible about their actions.
Say that again, please.
The breezes are more responsible about their actions.
Say that again, please.
The breezes are more responsible about their actions.
The breezes. I'm just going to reword that a little bit. Take more responsibility for their actions. What part in the book did you use as evidence for that?
The church.
The church? What happened to the church?
When it was on fire.
When it was on fire?
They risked their life.
Right. Okay, so you've got a quote from that section. Okay? So that's the example that you used. All right, somebody else give me a different point from their essay. What did you have, Bethany?
Yes, one friend did agree with the most important of each other.
Okay.
Because
we're going to
each other.
Okay, the Greases are more supportive of each other. And what part in the book do we use as an example for that?
The hospital. They visited during the hospital scene.
Yep.
I'll kind of disagree with the fire because they did start running in and they heard the voices and they thought that it was their fire.
However, what I'm teaching you here is how to structure an essay. The content of it in your exam is not going to be this content.
Yeah.
So I'm just using this to show you how to do an essay structure. So don't worry too much about the content. I'm not worried about that. What I'm teaching you at the minute is the actual structure of how to do a really good structure,
yeah.
And specifically in a conclusion. Okay, so these are two examples, right? So obviously in your essay, in your exam, you're gonna have three. Because you will have written three main body paragraphs by the time you get to your conclusion, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, so I already have that information, and so I shall be able to tick that off in my planning. Right, so I'm ready to begin writing my conclusion now. Okay, so this is going to be my conclusion. When you're writing an essay, do not label your paragraphs, introduction, main body paragraph one, conclusion. It is not a report. I do not want to see subheadings or labeling. You merely leave one line space between each paragraph, and then there can be no confusion. Okay? Right. So I actually want to start with my link to this. I'm not going to announce myself, because I don't want anybody to write in conclusion or in my essay I have shown. I don't want to hear any of that. I know you've written an essay because I'm reading it, okay? And I don't want to read in conclusion because I know, I can see that's actually your last paragraph, so that is your conclusion. Do not announce yourself. You merely go straight into it directly, and you do it well and you do it succinctly, but you ensure that you have all of these ingredients. Okay, so my link is, the Greases. The Greases are far better citizens. Far better citizens than the Socs. S. E. Hinton has shown us that having wealth does not necessarily make you a better citizen.
Are you just rewording what you said?
Yeah, so this is, remember, these are the notes that I did in my note on my note page, because I was looking at my acronym and I was trying to make sure I had all of that information together before going into my conclusion. A conclusion should not be just merely a poor cousin of your introduction. A conclusion should end succinctly and thoroughly and well, because that will show that you're writing with confidence and that you know what you're talking about. And this is what you want your marker to feel as well. Okay, so the Greasers are far better citizens than the Socias. Full stop. Essie Hinton, as we know is our author, has shown us that having wealth does not necessarily make you a better citizen. So have I done my link to the thesis?
Yes.
To the question? Yes, tick that. Have I discussed the author's purpose?
Yes.
Yes. Have I covered the topic of the essay?
Yes.
Yes. And have I done it in one sentence?
Yes.
No. How many sentences have I done it in?
Two.
Two. So even though we've got three things here, I've actually managed to link these two together quite successfully because we want it succinct. Succinct means it's not really wordy and goes on and on. We want to say what we need to say, but in the best way possible. Agreed?
Yes.
Okay, so now I'm going to go to my 3 points. So because this is just a trial run and we've only got two Peel paragraphs, this is the L part of main body paragraph. Because the L part should show me that further learning, that conclusion of each part. Okay, so the Greasers take more responsibility for their actions, for example in the fire, and the Greasers are more supportive of each other. Okay, so imagine there's three of these and not two. Now I need to find a way to synthesize them. To synthesize is to take all of the elements and blend them together, much like you would for colored threads in weaving a mat. Every element has its own color, but together it actually weaves a whole. Okay, so I don't particularly want to list them like I have in the introduction, because these come from the L part of the main body paragraph, the wording is actually going to be a little bit different. And what we're showing is a development. We've taken the three points that you first stated in your introduction, and now actually through your evidence and explanations, you've actually developed those ideas a little bit. And now we've come to our conclusion, we want to show that development succinctly. Okay, so the Greasers take more responsibility for their actions and the Greasers are more supportive of each other. I can say those two things together. The Greasers clearly are prepared to take responsibility for their actions and continually remain supportive of each other, even to the point of death, because of course the character died in the hospital, didn't he? Okay, so the Greasers clearly are prepared to take responsibility for their actions and continually remain supportive of each other, even to the point of death. Have I succinctly put together my main points?
Yes.
So I can tick that. So you can see I've got a tick box here to make sure that I've included everything that I need to in my conclusion to ensure that I've done a thorough job. Now finally, I need to end well. I need to end well. Can I think of a quote off the top of my head in the book?
Stay gold.
Stay gold? Did I already use that?
Yes.
Okay, so I don't want to double up. If I've used one quote somewhere, I don't want to use it again if I can help it. But that is actually a lovely quote, yep.
When Ponyboy says to Johnny, if it gets too rough, just come over to my place. So he's looking out for him, that if he feels uncomfortable, he can go up to theirs to calm.
Okay, I might actually develop that. I like that quote. So how's it begin?
It says, if it gets too rough, just come on over to my place.
If it gets too rough. Okay, ellipsis, which means that there are words that are carried on in that sentence, but I'm not stating them. And I'm closing my inverted commas because that's the end of the quote that I'm taking out of there. But I'm going to carry on in my own words now. If it gets too rough, comma, you can always count on a greaser. So I've actually used a quote from the text and then just carried on in my own words to complete the idea. If it gets too rough, you can always count on a greaser. It's not brilliant Mark Twain world-changing, but you know what? It fits with the essay that I've written and it makes sense and I was able to come up with something. So I'm actually quite happy with that. Okay, so I'm going to tick my end well because I found one. If I couldn't think of a quote to adapt, I might have gone along the lines of something like, great citizens have great hearts. I would have picked up a word from my thesis question or my thesis and just adapted that in some way. But as I said, if in doubt,
you can always count on.
Well done. Let's try that again. If in doubt,
leave it out.
Right. Okay. So you can see actually that my conclusion here, if you looked at it, the size of it, given that there would probably be one more little piece of information from my third main body paragraph, which isn't actually included here, the size of this paragraph would be actually quite similar to the size of the paragraph in our introduction. Would you agree?
Yeah. When you have to carry the author's purpose,
which I have here, Essie Hinton has shown us.
Oh, okay. So you added the one above it.
Yeah. So I could have said, instead of saying Essie Hinton has shown us, I could have actually said. Can you not do that, please? The noise.
Oh, that was me, sorry.
Is that you? Can you not do that, please? I could have actually said the author's purpose, but I've actually used her name instead and said Essie Hinton has shown us. But it's the same thing. Okay, are there any questions about writing a conclusion?
No.
Okay. Right, so guess what you have to do?
Write a conclusion.
I think we should, turn this off.
That's what we wanted.
How long does that go for?
It wasn't.
Where's the button?